We have around 40 Kohaku of the Izumiya koi farm. And in this video, I will explain you like which ones you should select and which ones you shouldn't select. And also explain that with examples. At the end of the video, I will show you which ones out of these 40 are the top picks for me personally and explain them in a little bit more detail. So if you want to know more about Kohaku, this is the right video for you, especially when you want to learn more details about Kohaku and which aspects you have to look for when you select a Tosai, a young Kohaku for your own pound. Okay, let's see. This is a nice two-step Kohaku. So I am selecting it for now. Pattern is good. The white is stopping right before the tail. The red is in between the eyes. So for now that is quite good. We call this Nidan Kohaku, by the way, because it is two-step. Another one. Also a two-step Kohaku. The nose is white, that is good. Fins are nice, no red on it. The tail section is white. What you can see is it has some orangish color in the white. That is red that disappeared. But I will select it for now, but I honestly don't think it will be one of the better ones. But let's see later. And then this one. One red eye, which I personally don't really like. Pattern is okay. Should have some stop in between, so white in between the red section. Then it would have been better for me, so I'm not selecting this one. So this one, the nose is nice and white. The red is in between the eyes. The pattern lays like in the middle of the body, like stop, the red stops below the lateral line, so that's good as well. Selecting this one as well. And this Kohaku, well, I think the pattern is kind of special, but too much white on one side. One side is red, other side is all white, so not one of my favorite ones. Not picking that one for now. All the other factors are good, by the way. Nice blue eyes. The red stops, red on the nose visible. The eyes are nice and clean. It has an O-dome, so the white section of the tail. So it is, well, nice, but I don't like the pattern. Not the best pattern at all. Then the next one. This one. Better pattern, but it has a white, like a window, we call it. It has a window on top of his head. So in the red, there is a section of white visible. And that's something, well, judges in Japan don't really appreciate. For that reason, I won't select it. And this Kohaku, we call this Sandan Kohaku, because it has three red steps. The nose is white. The red lace over the eye, I personally don't really like that, honestly. I also think that the patterns are a little bit too small. Something else that I don't like is red visible in the tail. Honestly, I won't select it. Also because it has a little black spot below, not selecting it. Although the pattern is quite interesting. So then this one, this is a straight hi Kohaku, or ippon hi. It actually is quite good. Doesn't have any red on the nose. The eyes are nice and white. Body is quite good. Straight body. O-dome, so the last section of the tail is white. There's a little bit of orange in the fin, in the pectoral fin, left one, which is not super good. The skin quality is quite good. It is shiny. The white is really white, so it is a good koi, but it is a straight he pattern, not appreciated a lot. The straight he actually can really look good, especially when the body becomes larger. Because of this pattern, it tends to look like that the body is stronger, only because the pattern is based on one step. So it looks more robust, basically. A straight he or ippon he means that the red pattern is like one out of one piece, so there are no red steps visible. For now, I won't select it. There are better ones in this bowl for sure. This one has Kutsibeni. The lips are red, as you can see. We call this Kutsibeni. Well, the tail section, there should be, like the last part of the tail should all be white. This one is not. Furthermore, the pattern is quite good. It's all above the lateral line of the side of the body. So it is not a bad koaku for sure. It's just not good enough for now. Red between the eyes is good. White nose is good. Kutsibeni makes it more playful and special. The fins are nice white. The tail is white. Only there is orange. The last part of the tail is orange, and it should be white for me, because that makes the body look way more stronger. So not selecting it, although it is a good koi for sure. Another one that I won't select, simply because the red isn't strong enough. You can see that it is slowly fading away. The red is, the red looks orange as well. Well, that is actually good, but the orange is really too light. You can see like on the shoulder section that some red already disappeared, and under the skin. So it's difficult to show you. It's not gotten good enough. Another one, Nidan Koaku, two-step. The balance of the pattern is not good enough. One red eye, tail section is not white, so no dome. Not selecting this one as well. And another one. And normally we call this Marutu Koaku if the head pattern would be round. So this red marking on the head, when it was round, it would be a Marutu Koaku. Well, it still is, but it's not really a good one. I think that the pattern is not really equal or not really symmetrical. The white color is good, the tail section is white. Pattern is not really special, it's one really big step. Not selecting this one as well for that reason. Then, this is quite a nice kohaku. One red eye, which I really don't appreciate a lot. The tail section is also not white. Pattern is quite playful and special. I'm selecting it and I will tell you later why I selected it. Then this one. The red lays over one of the eyes, not appreciated a lot, not a white tail, not selecting this one as well. This one, small, one red eye, pattern is not really balanced. The body is not so good as well. It's really thick hair and thin, the last part is really thin. It's not really a good body posture for a young koi, not selecting that one as well. Another one, red nose, pattern is like one step, there's a little black spot visible here, not really good visible, but it will become larger for sure. And these black spots we call shimmies, by the way, like a shimmy, like a really small dot that shouldn't be there. Furthermore, it is, okay, pattern is nothing special. Not selecting it for that reason as well. Small koaku, not really a perfect one as well. White, no white tail. The red lace over one eye. The sashi and kiwa isn't really good. So that has to do with the markings where they stop. So there's a lot of orange visible under the skin as well. It's not really appreciated a lot as well. It doesn't show good quality red color, so there's no good quality red color on this one. For that reason, won't select it. Another Marutan Koaku, three steps, one on the head, middle body, last part. And if this koi will grow larger, there won't be enough red visible on the koi. So now it is okay-ish, but there's not enough red visible. It will only be really small steps when this koi is like 60, 70, 80 cm in size. The pattern is too small, so I can't select it for that reason. This is now Ipponi because it is one step. But here in this area, the red will fade away. When it grows larger, the red lays over one of the eyes. There's a little bit of orange in the pectoral fin visible. I'm also not selecting it for that reason. This kohaku. So, quite good kohaku as well. Don't really like the head pattern because it looks like it's cut on the head. It's not really nice. It also has some small small spots in this area, which doesn't give it a clean look. Not selecting this one as well. One red eye, the nose, red on it. This is a little bit messy. I'm not selecting this kohaku as well. The balance in this kohaku is missing a little bit. There's too much red on one side, the other one is missing a bit, too much white. So now it looks like a large gap of white in this area. And for that reason I won't select it as well. I don't like the body posture a lot either. Too thick in this area. And honestly the red is not so good as well. It looks light in this area, near my finger. You can even see the white through the scales there, while on other areas you can't. So for that reason I'm not selecting this one. This kohaku, Ipponi, one big red pattern. Nose is white, it's good. White fins. A little bit of orange on the tail. Pattern is nothing special. Body is not the best one, not that straight. And for that reason I'm also not selecting this one. Really light color red, red in the tail, so a no-go for me. And by the way, I'm just selecting these, doesn't mean that I'm not, well, that the other ones are also sellable, but just, well, not the best ones. This one, I like the head pattern, it's really, really cool. It's really white as well. So that's good. This white section is really large. Personally, I don't like that. And also, the red seems to be fading a little bit on one side, on this side. On the white side, the red seems to be fading. So for that reason, I can't select it. An Ipponi kohaku. Good body posture. The red seems to be quite good. Nose is nice and white. The red lays between the eyes. It has an odome. So even though this pattern is nothing special, I am going to select this one. Then this kohaku, like one side is red. Yeah, it is quite okay. Tail section, white is good. The white is good quality as well. Body is a little bit slim compared with some of the others that I've selected, and for that reason I'm not picking it as one of the best picks. Red seems to be fading away a little bit. Also, it is over the eye, the tail is not white, so for that reason I'm not selecting it at this moment. So this one, strong body, playful pattern, odome is white, tail section is white, that's the odome. Fins are nice and white, clean eyes, clean nose, small red dot visible here. But still okay picking this one for now. Like the first half, the head and the shoulder is really heavy red on this coin, and the tail section almost doesn't have red. Also the body looks a little bit, it's broad here, smaller here. It's not really a torpedo looking coin, so I'm also not selecting this one. So this is quite a nice kohaku. It actually is a good kohaku. So I would have selected this one if the orange was not in this fin. And also the tail, there's one a little bit too much orange in the tail section, as you can see. So if it didn't have that, then I would have selected it. For now, not selecting it. So you already know that we are going to end up with some of the better kois, of course. I will put them back in the bowl very soon. Few more to go. This one, one of the smaller ones. It's a Marute koaku, so one almost round marking on the head. Not the best one. Some red seems to be fading away, as you can see in this area. So I can select it as well. Then a strong looking koaku, but the tail section should be white, in my opinion. Yeah, white fins as well, quite good. So I like it, but there's too much red in the tail, and I really only want the better picks out of this 40 koaku, so I'm not putting it in the bowl with the best ones. And we already saw it a lot that like the tail section is not white. Same for this one. The orange is not bad. On the gel, I think it shows that it could disappear there. Yeah, body posture is not super straight as well. A little bit broader, just behind the head. For now, a no-go. The tail is white. The head is still okay. One eye is a little bit in red. Pattern is really playful. And for that reason, I'm also selecting it. The white is really white. Nose is nice and white. Nice blue eyes. This is one of our picks. And like I said again, I will go back to the ones that I selected and give you more details about them and why I selected these. And by the way, when I started doing this, I had no clue which ones would be my top picks and which ones wouldn't be. So it's just random. The nose is white, that's good. Tail is white. Looks like on the tail that some red disappeared in the last period of time. And furthermore, it is nice softy. And for now, I am also putting this one in the bowl with selected ones. And look, this is a really cool koaku. Nice pattern. But you know, if this koaku is going to grow, the belly grows like upwards. And so at the sides of this red pattern, you will start to see more white when this koi is going to grow. And then this pattern, which at this moment, when this tosa is only like, well, 12 cm, I think, then it is quite nice. But when it is larger, it will really it will look like a really, really small pattern. And that won't be looking very fantastic at all. It is a nice koi, but for the future I can select it. Strong body, by the way. Good body, nice tail. A little bit of red on the tail. White is super white as well. So good shiroji, good white. Does it have an odome? Because there's still a little bit of red visible on the tail. Some red seems to be fading away. Not really fading away, but it's like there are differences in the red quality. Like if you compare the head to the tail section, for example. So for that reason, I'm also not selecting this one. And we have the last one. Also a really speedy one. Probably that's the reason why it's still in the bowl. Odome is good. Nose is good. It's nice and white. Quality of white is good. It's shiny. Some red seems to be fading away in this area. The white will come up when the skin gets thicker. Then the white in this area where it looks a little bit orange or pinkish, I'm not sure how to call it. Then you will see that actually the white is coming to overrule, and it will be super bright white again. It's a difficult one. I would select it, but balance of the pattern, it's too heavy in the first section compared with the tail. Yeah, for that reason I'm not selecting it. So the bowl is all empty. These are the ones that we selected for now. And what I will do is put these all back in the big blue bowl and then explain you a little bit more in detail why I have selected these ones. So I'll just place the entire bowl in there. There they are. Let's see. So the top picks by me, in my opinion, of course, and opinions are different for everyone. So let's see, we have 8 koaku in this bowl, and these are my 8 best ones out of the 40 that I just selected. And what I will do is bring it back to a top 3. Well, there's one that I selected, but now when I compare them with all the others, I can't select this one. This one, the body, it looks strong and thick. Well, it is. The pattern is okay. It's a little bit small maybe on the last part, because when it grows, like I said before, the body grows upwards. And you will see more white from the sides on like the on the back of the koi when it grows larger. And then I think that the red pattern will be too small, and also the body is a little bit too heavy already. It's a little bit, it's not looking like a torpedo, and at this age that's too big. So that's one out. Then I already spotted this one. Pattern is good, but it's too small. This section should have been a little bit larger. So no, I'm not selecting this one as well. Am I going to put out this one? Yes, I am. And there's one reason for that. And that is, I think I told it before when I first selected it, and that's the orange looks like it is disappearing on this side. The orange in this area is so light that it looks like it is fading away, and actually a little bit already faded away there. So that's not so good to have as one of your top picks, of course. Then this one, nice Nidan Koaku, nice two-step. But if I look at it again, you can see that the orange is not really equally, like symmetrically on the back. There's a lot of white in this area, and on the other area there's a lot of orange. Well, of course, none of the koi is perfect. But if I, sometimes when it swims towards me, you can see that for that reason it's not really. If you look at it like this, you will probably understand what I mean. The red is too heavy on this side compared with this side. And then, even though I like this one, it is the smallest out of the 4 that I have left, but I'm not going to select it. There's one small red dot here, small red dot on the tail. Yeah, it is a nice pattern, small red dot on the nose as well, but the red seems to be, yeah, scattered around a little bit, and that's not something. Well, it is nice and playful for sure. It is a good koi, believe me. And I believe this koi is really nice for a hobbyist to grow out and see what will happen. It's just for now not one of the best picks. So what we have left is 3 koi now, and I'm going to give you more details on these 3. So these are the 3 best ones in my opinion. And of course I will tell you a little bit more about them. So we do have 3 koaku left. The top picks out of the bowl that we had, and I will start with this Ipponhi Koaku. Tipponi means, I think I said it several times already, like straighty, like one big red pattern. The nose is nice, super white, the eyes are blue, all fins are entirely white. The red pattern stops just before the tail. And if I put this kohaku towards the ball like this, you will see that it has no red below the lateral line. So below the lateral line, halfway of the koi, this koi is entirely white. And typical for Ippon-hi, so the single red big pattern, is that if it also has a good body, well, the pattern will even make the body look even stronger because it is a single pattern. And as you can see, also the red perfectly in between the eyes, stops right before the nose. So this is a good kohaku, but you have to like the straight he pattern, of course. And I think most people won't pick that, but yeah. If we look only at quality, body posture, skin quality, it is a good pick. Then a kohaku that probably a lot of you would be picking as well. One of the more playful kohaku that we had in the bowl. Nice divided pattern. When this koi is going to grow, more white will come in between the first and the second step. So you can already see that it's really light there. We call this sashi. When this koi is becoming older, then this sashi will disappear. So yeah, nice pick. There's one thing that I personally don't really like on this kohaku, and that is that the right eye is red. Also, it would be even better if the last part of the tail was white. But still, overall really good koi. The red quality is good as well. It is all of the same intensity over the entire body. So it is a nice pick. And the last one that I have has this quality that I just explained, that it should have white right before the tail. So it has a good odome. The body posture is good. The skin quality is really nice. It's shiny. All the fins are white. Pattern is personal, but this one is playful. Yeah, we will have to see how this is going to look over a couple of years, of course. Seems to have good potential for the future. My personal favorite is this one. So it would be nice if you also share which of the ones is your favorite. Is it the straight he, Ippon he one, this one? That will surely look huge when it grows because of the pattern. Is it going to be this one with the nice pattern, playful pattern as well, right? Nice white tail section, blue eyes, good one as well. Or is it the third one that is also my number one? Let me know in the comments. Thank you again for watching. Hopefully this was insightful as well for you. And if you like these kind of videos, please leave a comment, let me know, and I will make sure that I upload more videos like this, where we select some nice tosai. Thank you for watching. Make sure to subscribe and see you in the next video.